स्टूडेंट्स, सो लास्ट क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस। टुडे वी शैल नो अ फ्यू मोर केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस। एंड टू नो द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस, वी मस्ट कंडक्ट एन एक्टिविटी। सो द एक्टिविटी विल बी रिलेटेड टू हाउ डू मेटल्स कार्बोनेट एंड मेटल हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट्स रिएक्ट विद एसिड। सो इट विल बी 2.1.3 इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक, दैट इज हाउ डू मेटल कार्बोनेट्स एंड मेटल हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट्स रिएक्ट विद एसिड्स। एंड टू नो अबाउट द केमिकल रिएक्शन बिटवीन दीज केमिकल कंपाउंड्स, वी मस्ट हैव टू कंडक्ट एन एक्टिविटी, एंड द एक्टिविटी विल बी 2.5 इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स। एंड वॉट आर द केमिकल्स दैट विल बी इन्वॉल्व टू परफॉर्म दिस एक्टिविटी? सो द केमिकल्स विल बी sodium carbonate, and the molecular formula of sodium carbonate is Na2CO3. Sodium hydrogen carbonate NaHCO3, dilute hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, and lime water, which is a root whose chemical name is calcium hydroxide solution. Calcium hydroxide in general term is known as lime water, and the chemical formula for calcium hydroxide is CaOH. Now, before going to conduct an activity, first we must know what is meant by metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates. Students, you can understand these chemical compounds through their name itself. So metal carbonate, it means any metal, okay, any metal with carbonate. So what is carbonate? Carbonate is a mixture of carbon and oxygen. So carbonate is nothing but it's a mixture of carbon and oxygen together, that is CO3. This CO3 is nothing but the carbonate. So any metal, if it combines with carbonate, that is CO3, then it will be considered as metal carbonate. For example, you can see here there is a sodium carbonate. Which is the metal in this one? Sodium. Sodium is the metal, and carbonate, that is CO3. So metal with carbonate, metal carbonate. Clear? And similarly, metal hydrogen carbonate. So what is this metal hydrogen carbonate? It's nothing but any metal with a mixture of hydrogen, carbon and oxygen. Together they will call it as hydrogen carbonate. So any metal with hydrogen carbonate. So what is hydrogen carbonate? It's a mixture of, so I'll write it here, carbonate is nothing but a mixture of carbon and oxygen, whereas the hydrogen carbonate, HCO3. Hydrogen carbonate, it's a mixture of hydrogen, carbon and oxygen. Carbonate is nothing but it's a mixture of carbon and oxygen only, whereas hydrogen carbonate is a mixture of hydrogen, carbon and oxygen. So if any metal combines with carbon and hydrogen, that will be considered as metal carbonate, and if any metal, if they combine with hydrogen, carbon and oxygen together, then that will be considered as metal hydrogen carbonate. And you can see the example for this here. So Na2CO3, sodium carbonate, it's an example for this metal carbonate, whereas sodium hydrogen carbonate, you can see here there is a metal sodium and there is a hydrogen carbonate. So this is an example for metal hydrogen carbonate. Clear students? Now we shall see the chemical reactions between metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonates with acids through an activity. The reaction of metal carbonates with acids. So take about 2 test tubes, take about 0.5 gram of sodium carbonate, that is Na2CO3, in one of the test tubes.
Again, take about 0.5 gram of sodium bicarbonate, that is NaHCO3, in another test tube. Now add about 2 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid HCl in both test tubes. Place a rubber cork. Observe the gas bubbles in both test tubes. Pass the evolved gas through the lime water, that is calcium hydroxide solution, by using the delivery tube. Observe the chemical reactions. So what's our observation? Carbon dioxide is produced with bubbles in a liquid. You can observe here, lime water becomes cloudy when the evolved gas passes through it, and also the white precipitates of calcium carbonate, that is CaCO3, is formed here as the precipitate. So the chemical equations for the chemical reactions conducted will be, from the test tube 1, sodium carbonate with HCl will form sodium chloride with water with carbon dioxide, that is Na2CO3. With hydrochloric acid will form NaCl with water with the liberation of carbon dioxide gas. Whereas in test tube 2, sodium hydrogen carbonate with dilute hydrochloric acid will form sodium chloride with water with carbon dioxide. That is NaHCO3 with dilute HCl will form sodium chloride NaCl with H2O with the liberation of CO2. If the gas evolved is passed through the lime water, then it will turn the lime water to the white precipitate, and the equation will be CaOH twice in aqueous solution, that is CaOH, calcium hydroxide, students. So calcium hydroxide, when this is passed through carbon dioxide gas CO2, it will form CaCO3 with water, that is called white precipitate, calcium carbonate and water. Whereas again, if the calcium carbonate is treated with water and carbon dioxide, it will form CaHCO3 twice. That is, calcium carbonate with water with carbon dioxide will give calcium hydrogen carbonate in the aqueous solution. So from the reactivity, we can conclude that the reaction of metal carbonates and hydrogen carbonates with acids gave corresponding salt, carbon dioxide and water. The generalized form of these chemical reactions are as shown. So metal carbonates, when treated with acid, they will form salt, carbon dioxide and water. Whereas metal hydrogen carbonate, if they are treated with acid, even they too will form salt, carbon dioxide and water.
So what's the conclusion or the inference of the activity that we have conducted? Metal carbonate, if they are treated with acids, they will form salt with carbon dioxide and with water. Whereas metal hydrogen carbonates, if they are treated with acids, even they too will form the similar compounds, that is salt, carbon dioxide and water. Metal carbonates, when treated with acids, they will form salt, carbon dioxide and water. Similarly, even metal hydrogen carbonates, if they are treated with acids, even they will form the salt, carbon dioxide and water. So this activity gave us another chemical property of acids and bases, that is, so any metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, if they are treated with acids, they will form salt, carbon dioxide, water. Now we will perform one more activity and we will see one more chemical reaction, and that is 2.1.4 in your textbook. How do acids and bases react with each other? So we will conduct an experiment to know how acids and bases together, how they will perform, how they will react. So to this, there is an activity 2.6 in your textbook that we have to conduct. So, and the chemicals used in this activity 2.6 are dilute NaOH solution. Now, what is NaOH? NaOH is nothing but the sodium hydroxide solution. Okay, and this sodium hydroxide solution, what it is? It is a base, right? And the other chemical that is we are using is dilute hydrochloric acid. And what is it? Is HCl. HCl is a acid. So we are using a base and an acid to react with each other. And we will take one more chemical, that is a indicator, which is phenolphthalein indicator. Right, all right. So these are the three chemicals that we are going to use in this activity: NaOH solution, which is a base; dilute HCl, which is an acid; and an indicator, that is phenolphthalein. But students, before we conduct an activity, so I must say you one thing, that if we are conducting an a reaction between an acid and a base, then that kind of reaction, it will give salt and water. Okay, and that kind of reaction will be considered as neutralization reaction. It's a very important definition and a question which has repeatedly asked in your previous examination of 10th standard. So do remember this term, neutralization reaction, very well. So what is neutralization reaction? And a reaction between an acid and a base. So it's a reaction between an acid and a base. So to give salt and water, this reaction is known as neutralization reaction. So what is neutralization reaction? A reaction between a salt, a base and a acid to give salt and water. Such kind of reaction will be known as neutralization reaction. Now we will see this neutralization reaction by conducting an activity.
So take a test tube, clean it using a clean dropper. Pour 10 drops of hydrochloric acid carefully in the test tube. Now add 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator solution. Observe the color changes. Now add sodium hydroxide solution drop by drop to the test tube. Shake it well after adding each drop. Observe the change in the color of the solution. Keep adding the sodium hydroxide drop by drop until the color begins to turn pink. You can see the pink color here. So once again, add drop by drop hydrochloric acid to the solution mixture until the solution in the test tube becomes colorless. Now what do we observe through this activity? In this activity, we observe that there is no change in the color of hydrochloric acid while adding phenolphthalein solution. Whereas the color of the solution in the test tube becomes pink by adding a drop of sodium hydroxide solution. The pink color of the mixture solution becomes colorless by adding a few drops of hydrochloric acid. Finally, we learned that if we add excess base, that is sodium hydroxide, to acidic solution, that is hydrochloric acid, it converts to a base. Similarly, we can change base into acids. We also learned that effect of base is nullified by an acid. When acids and bases are mixed in definite proportions, they give a neutral solution. And hence, this is a neutralization reaction.
So what was the reaction of the activity conducted? So when sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH, when treated with hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, it will form NaCl, sodium chloride, and H2O water. So this NaOH is a base. So finally, it gave a neutralization reaction. So NaOH, it is a base, and HCl, it is an acid. When a base is treated with the acid, it will, in a definite proportion, it will form salt, there is NaCl and water. That forms a neutralization reaction. An acid and base together, they will react to form a salt and a water, and such kind of reactions are known as neutralization reactions. So today we got to learn two more chemical properties of acids and bases, and the further properties of the further content will be continued in the next class. Thank you.